I'm holding an electrolytic capacitor in my hand right now. I'm not sure if you've ever noticed this before or not, but if you look at the top of one of these electrolytic capacitors, you might notice that there are some indentations in the case. The reason these capacitors have these indentations is so that if the capacitor were to happen to explode, then it would explode in a controlled way and shrapnel wouldn't fly all over the place. It's unlikely for these capacitors to explode if they're wired up correctly. Now, the particular capacitor I'm holding right now is a 220 microfarad capacitor that's rated at 50 volts. Now, that means if I charge the capacitor up to any voltage less than 50 volts, we should be safe. One other important thing about these capacitors to keep in mind is that the polarity is important. You might notice that there's a row of minus signs along one side of the capacitor. The other side doesn't have any symbols at all, so this is the positive side. Now, what happens if we were to apply the wrong polarity to this capacitor? What happens if we wire the positive side to the side that's marked with the negative symbol? Well, that's what we're going to test right now. So I've got a breadboard and a DC power supply. Let's orient the capacitor so that we've got the minus side over here, and I'm going to put a red wire on the minus side. I've got a black wire over on the positive side, so I've done it backwards intentionally. I've got a DC power supply over here, and we'll use this channel. I'll hook red to red and black to black so that when the DC power supply shows a positive voltage, the capacitor will see the wrong polarity. So we'll turn it on. The output is off for the moment. I'm going to turn the current all the way up to compliance, which means that this power supply should be able to supply 3.27 amperes if called upon to do that. The voltage right now is zero and the output is off. To protect ourselves from the explosion that we might have, we've got a box made out of acrylic. This is thick enough that we should be safe. All right, I'm going to quickly turn it on and turn the voltage all the way up to the maximum that the power supply can give us. So there we are. It can give us up to 30 volts, but we can see that we already have more than 3 amperes of current flowing, and the capacitor is not too happy about that. I better shut it off. It's important to pay attention to polarity when working with these electrolytic capacitors. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.